To obtain a new 3-jaw chuck for a Unimat SL is pretty much impossible. The problem here is the spindle, which is M12x1 thread, and all the later Emco models had an M14x1 thread. This machine is over 60 years old, which means that spare parts are rare no matter what. Still, however, this is a very popular machine because it's said to have a very high quality. Thereby, spare parts are even rarer, and a 3-jaw chuck is basically the most important part you can have on your lathe. And of course, they go whack, just like mine did. So they're extremely hard to come by. You do not find any new or unused ones. They're mostly used and scratched, and you still have to pay an arm and a leg for it. I think it's just not worth it, because I might end up paying a whole lot of money for a chuck that just isn't any better than the one I had. So what I did was obtain a 3-jaw chuck for the Emco Unimat 3, which is the follow-up model. New, unused, in its box, only with an M14x1 thread in the back. The original SL model 3-jaw chuck had a backing plate and thereby had no threads in the back whatsoever. And that's my idea here. I'm going to machine out the M14x1 threads, make a cylindrical register diameter in here, and machine a backing plate to go onto here, drill 3 mounting holes for screws in the front, and hope to be able to convert this chuck to M12x1. Here is the owner's manual of the Unimat SL, and you can see here the 3 screw holes in there. And you can perfectly drill these because the scroll has a larger diameter than the hole diameter would be of these, so you're not interfering with that. And here in one of the first chapters you can actually see how the chuck flange is machined, and they're opting for a diameter of 17 millimeters on the register, which is exactly what the through hole on this is. So I'm planning to make a mandrel in my other lathe, which I chuck this thing on so that it's running perfectly true on the mandrel, and then machine this out for as big accuracy as I can get. And for a chuck flange, I have this leftover sprue from a foundry, which is out of cast iron, so it should machine nicely and it shouldn't wear out the spindle. And as you can see, I've got plenty of attempts here. So here is the mandrel we made, and I've took a very light finishing pass in order to give it the smoothest and most accurate finish that I could get. And we're just going to chuck our smaller 3-jaw chuck right onto here. And since this shaft is running true with the lathe axis, the chuck basically is too, because this is the way that it would grab stock. So when we machine this out, this should be exactly parallel to the axis that it's grabbing onto. Thank you.
have fun. When all's said and done, there'll only be one Lucille. Though she made me feel blue, if she wanted me to, I'd beg, I'd steal. I could never forget, I'd never regret, the day that I met Lucille. I'm not looking for a new love, with the old love on my mind. Though it wasn't quite a true love, I know a new love is harder to find. What a sweet memory in every rose I can see. Lucille, so real, though she whispered goodbye, I know till I die, she'll always be my Lucille.
In there with a stick and a little bit of emery paper on the lathe, and that was really all it took. So that now you can see it screws on, and then about half the way it starts getting a little tight, but not binding, so that you can thread it on all the way. I will now rough out the contour on the big lathe and do the finishing work on this machine to make it exactly true to this very spindle.
I'm betting everything I've got on you. I'm giving all my love to one baby. Lord help me if my baby don't come through. I've got a great big amount saved up in my love account. Money and I've decided love divided in two won't do. So I'm putting all my eggs in one basket. I'm betting everything I've got on you.
Thank you. here, pretty much the same, maybe 500s. Which, for a three-jaw chuck, is pretty alright. So there you go. That's how you convert a M14x1 chuck to an M12x1 chuck, and how to put an old watchmaker's lathe back into service. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Let me tell you one thing though, cast iron is a f***ing mess.